might be some of you have asked yesterday why it's worth for us to update the engine, to redesign the complete engine just to reach 5 horsepower more than the previous one. So in fact, let me give you some arguments why we can justify this, to update the engine, to build a complete new engine, base engine, because it's not only the horsepower which we achieve. The main argument was, the first argument, is the legislation in California for emission and, of course, of the federal states. We now have to fulfill with this engine ULEV2 in California and the corresponding legislations here in the rest of the USA. And the second point is the fuel price all over the world increases, you know. And so we have to develop an engine which decreases the fuel consumption. And you can see it as a result on the Moroni label in the cars. Every car there's a sticker. For the 2.7 liter, we have now in the highway cycle 32 miles per gallon. 32 miles per gallon for a sports car. It's quite a value which is very important. For the city cycle, we have 23 miles per gallon. So, how could we achieve this fuel consumption improvement? Mainly by working in the detail of the technical parts of this engine. First of all, of course, the intake system. We have improved the intake system. We have adapted the diameters and the length of the complete intake system to the new performance of the 3.4 liter engine and for this 2.7 liter with the more air to be sucked in. The air comes on the left side of the car behind the driver through this hole, through the air filter, will be controlled by the throttle body here and distributed to both banks of the flat six-cylinder engine. Here's the distribution line which distributes to the left and right bank. There are flaps inside the induction system which will be controlled by the motronic, by the electronic of the engine management system, and depending on the revolution and on the load, the flaps will be opened or closed just to give the best airflow and air mixture in the cylinder. So this is why we achieved more horsepower. And the effectiveness of the induction system improves the fuel consumption. Then we have here another improvement of the engine, the camshaft and the valve lifting. From the predecessor, we have taken over the camshaft, the variable cam, which means that we have we can adjust the inlet cam to provide for each revolution the best closing points of the inlet valves. We have an oil-driven vane-type oil adjuster of the camshaft here. You can see it here. We have a 40-degree value for adjusting the camshaft relatively to the crankshaft. This will be done here by an oil-driven vane-type adjuster. This was on the previous engine as well. The new thing on this engine, and this is why we receive some fuel consumption improvements, is the Vario Cam Plus. The plus stands for the valve lifting, for different valve lifting. We have the cup tappets divided in two pieces. While the inner part is working directly on the inlet valve and moves it. And the outer part is concentric on this cup tappet and is connected together with two striker pins. So they are moving, if the striker pins are closed, moving together. Also, the camshaft above is divided into two parts. One, the outer cams are the big, responsible for the big valve lifting, and they are working on the outer cap, cup tappet. And if the outer cap tappet is connected with the pins, with the striker pins to the inner part, the big cam is responsible for the valve lifting. We have the big lift. For the 3.4, it's 10.4 millimeters, and here we have 9.4 millimeters for the 2.7 liter engine, and the big valve lift. But if the oil pressure is released, this is pins are worked by an oil pressure. If the oil pressure is released, a spring force can put the pins out, and the two cap tappets are separately, and only the inner part is working on the valve lifting, and the inner part of the cam is responsible for the valve lifting. So then we have this small valve lifting, which is 3.6 millimeters. The outer parts are of course also driven by motion, moved by the outer cams, but without any function. So, why is this responsible for the fuel consumption reduction? Because the in low revolutions and in idle, we only activate the smaller valve lifting, and so we can reduce the throttle losses, and this improves the effectiveness of the engine. Even if you are cruising on a highway or on a motorway in a very calm way without any acceleration, then this works in a small needle lift, valve lifting, and so even therefore you have this fuel consumption reduction, which leads then to the 32 miles per gallon value. So these are the main purpose here of this VarioCam Plus, fuel reduction. The other purpose is because we are now free for the design of the big cams for reaching performance, we don't have to take into account that we have to control a stable idle. So we are free to optimize the big cams for good performance. Another thing for fuel consumption reduction is the cylinder head. We have redesigned the cylinder head. First to put in this additional oil control valve for the VarioCam Plus, but as well we have overworked the water casement of the cylinder head, and we have put some additional coolings quite right into between the two outlet valves to get a cooler temperature at this area. This enforces us to have, or this prevents knocking on the engine, and this allows us to ignite the mixture later, which has a direct influence on the effectiveness and so on the fuel consumption of the engine. Another point is we could increase, because of this cooler engine head, we could increase the compression ratio from 11.0 to 11.3, which also has a direct effect on the effectiveness and so on the fuel consumption. All these points lead to the reduction of the fuel. Another point is also we have overworked the exhaust system. To fulfill this ULF2 requirements, we have increased the catalyst surface in the pre-catalyst, which is right here on the exhaust manifold. And so we could decrease the catalyst in the muffler and could use this additional volume in the muffler for creating some sound. And this is what the engineers want to do. They have to fulfill, of course, the legislations and the requirements for horsepower, but on their own wish, and this is our personal wish, we want to create a good sound of the engine. And so what we could do here was we did on the exhaust system. This additional volume we used for creating some more sound. We have put in some different tubes and some holes inside the exhaust system, first to reduce the back pressure. This means higher performance. And on the other side, we create some sound. and you can hear it when you're driving your car. So these are the main news of this engine. It's in the same case for the 3.4 liter engine as for the 2.7. So in principle, they are, have the same basic engine. Basic engine. What I want to tell you is that in fact the driver is the one who determines what sound and what system is working. If the driver is very, driving very smoothly without any acceleration, without any big gas pedal, then the engine is driving in a smooth condition and is saving fuel. Yeah? The small valve lifting is in action. The flaps are in the smooth position. They are closed. But if you really want to drive and accelerate, then all the sound system takes into, starts working. And the flaps are in the sound position. Here the Vario 10 Plus are in the performance position. This means the big camshafts are in action in mesh. And also the exhaust system, the waves, the acoustic waves in the exhaust system creates this great sound, which you can feel when you drive today, especially on those roads for today. And if the top is open and you're driving at a mountain wall where the sound is really reflected directly to your ears. So, and I wish you today a good drive and a good experience with the sound of the new Boxster engine.
Thank you, Martin.
On the Vario cam, is that, you talk about steadiness, but how about RPM? Say you're running at, you know, 4,500, 5,000 RPM, can you still be on the small valve?
No, no. Okay. This, there's, depending on the area where you are, it's mainly in the low RPM and low load.
Okay.
In this area you are with these small valve, but if you are driving at 3000 RPM, we switch over to the big valve.
Okay. Also, what does this engine have in common with the 911 motor? Is there anything in common, or is the base block the same?
The base block for the 3.4 liter is the same as the 3.6 liter.
Okay.
Yeah. But this is specific for the 2.7. The Vario 10 Plus, of course, has both engines, the 911 and the Boxster engine. And the induction system is the same as for the 3.6 Carrera engine. 3.8 has a larger one. And of course, the exhaust system is specific to the Boxster because the design of the car is completely different.
Questions? Okay, looks like you all wanted to drive.